Magic in the morning. It's Monday morning, and our special guest is Russell Brand. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Thank you so much for coming in.
I'm honoured to be in this room.
Well, you listen in the gym, don't you?
That's right. This will be on in the gym. Sadly, I won't be able to hear myself, although I am listening to me right now. But, this will be played in my gym where I get moderately fit.
Your fellow gym mates will be listening to you, though.
A lot of them try to cut off emotionally. I think that when you were saying coming up Russell Brand, at that point, some of them have Van Goghed their way out of that situation.
Switch to smooth.
Or chop their ear off. I mean, switching to smooth is a less radical solution. If only Van Gogh had said, instead of cutting my ear off, I'll just switch to smooth. Well, some would say that's worse, Vincent.
No, they definitely would say we would. You got a new tour. Rebirth.
Oh, yes.
I went to see the Messiah Complex.
Thank you.
I was exhorsted at the end of it.
Honestly, well, think
really
about
hard
me,
work
mate.
In the audience. Watch it, because it's just, I'm trying to keep up with
you. Thankfully, you were one of the people that was dragged off afterwards. That's where the real work began. Really, because, I suppose it was sort of, in a way, quite a... Messiah Complex was, icons, iconography and heroism, and Rebirth is, I suppose, about, well, look at me now. There's been a lot of changes. I'm a father now. I've had, a sort of mad few years working in media, working in Hollywood. So it's sort of, in a way, it's my... attempts to understand that and get something out of that, and is rebirth possible, particularly at a time when so many of us feel like we need it.
Yeah. Is rebirth possible?
It's got to be, isn't it? Yeah. I mean, it's all throughout culture, the idea of metamorphosis. And what's that when snakes shed their skin? There's a really good word for that.
Oh, yeah.
It's a surprising word. It's something like sedatic or sybaratic or... Someone will know. One of your listeners will know.
Yes, they're a clever bunch, much cleverer than I am. So is rebirth a lot about becoming a dad, being a dad?
Yeah, and it's about how becoming a parent has changed me, has changed my opinion of myself, changed my sense of priorities in the world, but how, in a way, it becomes more important to engage with the way we see the world. But how do we do
totally.
That now?
Yeah, and as you say, at the moment, it's so scary. I'm a relatively new dad, a little bit ahead of you. I've got twins, they're just over two.
Congratulations, mate.
Just over two, so I can give you many a tip. Because your little girl's, 3 months?
My baby daughter is 3 months old. She's waking up 3 times in the night again. My girlfriend feeds her, so it's like I am... able to somewhat escape the hardcore nighttime aspects of this. But I tell you what, though, there's everything is different, isn't it? Your whole identity becomes different. It's just a whole new person living in the house. We've made a relative. What do you do? So it's absolutely
You're like this relative, though.
Absolutely. That is my relative that I like. Yeah. It's a good job it's not like another uncle.
Not like your Uncle John. You do not want another Uncle John.
Don't want
him
turning up in the house, all demanding, half cut.
Exactly.
Kicking around, hoofing up carrots out the allotment.
But you're right. It's scary. And your emotions change so much. So when you watch things on the telly affect you more. I don't know if you find this. So when you see the ads for various things, like ads for dogs and stuff like that, you become much more emotional about everything. And as you say, you think about the world, you think about what's the world going to be like in 20 years when my little one's grown up a bit.
I suppose it's one of the things, having a child, it does overwhelm the general conditioning for self-centeredness, for sort of thinking, all that matters really is that I look nice and I find the right hair products. Mm. Suddenly becomes a secondary note.
Yeah, absolutely. And you spend the rest of your life with just a little snot patch on your shoulder at all times, even when you've washed your top. I don't think there's one on that one, though. Is that a new one?
This morning I kissed her before I came out to work, but I didn't pick her up or give her any opportunity to to do that. So sometimes you can do projectile vomiting. It's just surprising, snake venom, a little jet of it. It doesn't, the trajectory is sufficient for it to actually leave the mouth entirely. It's without trace, a bullet.
And absolutely no warning whatsoever. They can be smiling and giggling and then bang. Just arrives.
Without warning. Mm. What terrifying times we live in.
Yeah, mine are just about to get out of their cots now. That's a scary time. Yeah.
They're sussing the cot
they're
system.
Sussing,
I'll just climb my way out.
Yeah, yeah. Well, they worked out to take
what
their...
What have you got, boys or...?
One of each, boy and a girl.
Cool.
The girl is so much worse than the boy. She's worked out to get the grow bag thing that they live in.
Yeah, that sleep suit thing.
Yeah.
I know that.
So we've now tied up the two zips at the bottom and we've stitched up the arm so she can't... Well, not totally. Stitched so she can't quite pull her arms.
She's
out.
Hannibal Lecter'd up nice,
basically.
Your daughter.
Yeah, she is.
Before an evening. Yeah, Hannibal
is.
Lecter, when he's in that bit where he goes, when you see your daughter... Da, 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 da. I mean, that's not necessarily how he sounds. I made no promises in that area. But Hannibal Lecter does need to be strapped up sometimes.
Absolutely. Have you been left on your own with her yet?
Oh, yeah.
That's scary as well.
Yeah, quite. Not a lot, but it's a sort of notable occasions because, yesterday we were on our own. We were on our own and I put on Peppa Pig, why not? And, she did, was looking at it for a while. It was quite a good episode, actually. But then, it was one where, the But they're playing a computer game, Daddy Pig and George and Peppa. And then my daughter sort of stopped being interested in that narrative long before I had become tired of it. And she sort of cried. So I had to negotiate. What is this? What do you want? A lot of the time it's stand up and hold me. She seems to detect a distinct difference between sit down, hold and stand up, hold. So I don't know. I'm holding a baby a lot. I'm standing up a lot. Things have changed.
It sounds like you've got it off to a tee here.
Thanks, mate.
You
want to
Google wheels on the bus, and you'll get a whole hour after that of really weird kids' nursery rhymes, trancy versions of them.
Oh, I'd like that.
Indian kind of Punjabi-type versions of them as well.
I'd like that. I'd be down with that.
Just Google wheels on the bus.
Any way of getting Bangra culture into my daughter, I'm up for.
So what else about Rebirth? Tell us what other things we could expect.
Are we talking about like the mad year that I had? It's like, you know, it's got, obviously there's bits with like, you know, like there's a personal address from Donald Trump in it. I've got Donald Trump sort of like, I've got a lovely bit of footage of him criticising me. I've got amazing footage of things that I was doing like in politics. I've got what I feel about what's happening politically now and how that relates to the personal, and in my case, how it relates to the spiritual. And but one of the things that's really good is every person that comes, they fill in a survey, right? And there's questions on there that you wouldn't believe. What's the most embarrassing thing you've ever done? What's the worst thing you've ever said to anybody? What's the worst bit of parenting advice you've ever done? What's your proudest sexual memory? Your most embarrassing sexual memory? People just put it down in a survey and give it to a show off. Me.
Yeah, crazy. Just write no comment.
It's like the British arms trade. Don't give that to them, you idiot. They'll misuse it.
Well, we've got a bit of a survey going on the show this morning. We're asking people, when was the last time they hid as an adult? Can you remember?
Oh.
Mine was
only
the other day.
Last time I hid as an adult. Well, go on, what's yours?
Well, mine was the other day when a friend turned up and I didn't want to be in because she talks a lot. I felt like such a...
Hold on, you're on the radio, mate. What are you doing?
I don't talk a lot, not compared to her.
No, I'm saying she's going to know that you were in and you hid. What did you do, lay on the floor?
She didn't like me that much. Yeah, I lay on the floor and she knew. I think she knew I was there because she knocked.
You could tell from the knock.
And kept knocking.
Come on.
And she peered through the lounge window.
Oh, that's very, very...
What about you?
Where
you
were
remember?
You behind the settee?
Well, I was on the floor and I kind of crawled toward... I didn't actually get behind, but I was crawling towards that general direction.
The sanctuary of the sofa.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. When did I last hide as an adult? I mean, I've not indulged in any criminal activity for quite a long time. So
I'm not trying to catch you out here.
So there's no like sort of jumping over hedges or being in an airport toilet out of breath, trousers and pants down, frantically trying to make a compromise with myself and the smuggling laws. So anything I have done like that, it would have been quite innocuous. And I am trying to sort of face up to things these days, to the consequences of my action. And even with that friend though, basically, phone always on silent, house phone, I try not to answer it. Basically, I'm thinking of going to live in a burrow.
Not a bad idea, with the way the world is at the moment, I don't think.
We'll just all be come out underground eventually.
Come out and do the odd rebirth and then get back in.
Shoot back into the with the other bedrooms.
Back into the burrow. Russell, we've got a guy on the phone who says he knows you.
Quite possible. I've lived a very diverse life. And
so
I'm
going
to
put him on. There is a picture of him and you here that he sent through. So he's definitely been in the same space as you. Let's see if you remember him. Morning, mystery person.
Good morning, Russell and other person. How are you?
Oh, I like the sound of him already. I think we could really crack on, me and this guy.
So give Russell a couple of clues as to where you met and how you met.
Russell, you was doing a film in London on the sixth floor of a hotel.
I remember that day. That was doing Get Him to the Greek. It was in like sort of Hanover Square or something like that.
No, that was another square, but we moved to a hotel further down by the river underneath the Millennium Wheel.
Oh, yeah, I know that. I know what you're saying.
Yeah, and something happened, didn't it, when you were filming down there?
Something always happened, mate. I'm me, aren't I? I'm always going to struggle in any circumstances. What was it? Well, tell me specifically, as long as it doesn't, as long as it's, like, legal, announce it to the listeners of Magic.
It was definitely legal, and what happened was I was a chauffeur, and somebody didn't turn up to do a part in a scene with you.
Oh!
Is it all clicking in now?
Yeah, it is. This guy can do it. He's brilliant. Oh, yeah, here you are, and here is the actual evidence. Oh, my God, you look so much. In your underpants, you are a beauty. I tell you, like, Peter, listeners, I'm sure this has been put up on Magic's social media
feed now.
Yeah, how lovely to see you. Please remind me of your name. I mean, but I tell you what, I remember your buttocks perfectly.
It's Alan Moore, but
all right, Alan.
Probably known that day as Speedo Man.
I do remember that. I remember that whole business. That was a curious affair, wasn't it? Yeah, down that hotel, down by the, like, right off of Westminster Bridge, I think that hotel is, isn't it?
That's right.
And but the thing that most listeners will care about is seeing you in these sort of snakeskin print lurid Technicolor Speedo underpants, lovely kettle on your wrist, gorgeous torso, if you don't mind me saying, Alan. I mean, if they're looking for another James Bond, I might be good as the villain, but if they want someone to fill Craig's blue trunks, they look. Need look no further from this image here.
It's Morsey the trucker. Morsey, thank you so much for coming on. We're going to tweet that picture to the world.
Thank you very much. He's already been round half of Watford and St Albans.
So Watford is the world and St Albans is the Milky Way.
Well, you take care and I hope the show goes well. I know you're in Watford. But
if you want to come, see, I'll be in Watford. We'll sort you out, mate, with tickets. So, like, get in touch. I wouldn't accept your money. Not now I've seen you in your underpants.
There you go. You just got yourself a free pair of tickets to Rebirth. Well done.
Yeah, lovely.
Cheers, Alan.
Cheers. Cheers, Russell.
Russell, on that bombshell, we got to go. Thank you so much for coming
Thanks
in this morning.
Thanks for having me.
Rebirth
I've
tickets.
Got your phone in, mate. It's never class. Leave an idiot with your phone. All right, there you go. Take that, please.
Tickets to Rebirth are on sale. Go and see him. Very funny man. Russell Brand, thank you.
Thank
Good luck
you.
With the little girl as well.
You're so kind. Good luck with your kids.